Welcome to the video news of the week. On Thursday, Governor Chris Sununu made a swing through the region, which included an afternoon stop in Colebrook, where he met with constituents at the Moose Muck Coffee House and sat down with the Colebrook Chronicle for an interview. We asked him how he felt about the Balsams redevelopment project.
Look, I think fundamentally the Balsams project would be terrific. I mean, I grew up going to the Balsams. To bring it back and to do it in a modern, sustainable way would be a huge boon to the North Country and a huge boon to the entire state, frankly. And I think the plans that Les has proposed, they're aggressive, they're bold, but they would be just a huge economic driver. Whether it's drawing up from the greater Boston and southern New Hampshire area or drawing down from Montreal and Quebec, I think it could be a great success here if done right.
We also asked Sununu to speak about his vocal support for the Northern Pass Transmission Line project.
I understand some people are going to be against it for certain reasons, completely. But I also understand this is part of a long-term greater economic impact for the entire state and all of New England. So it's a win. It really is. People have to understand, I hope they look at the big picture. I hope they look at, you know, we're not just a one-issue state, whether you're talking about the economy or healthcare or education. It's a lot of other great things going on in New Hampshire. And I hope they see the bigger impact of, that this is going to have across the state. Over time, I have no doubt that that is going to be the issue. Over time, I have no doubt that Northern Pass gets done. We stabilize our energy market. People move on. Unlike other governors of the past, we're not campaigning on the first day. I said for the first year minimum, we're going to ignore politics. We're going to find out what does the state need and put everything we can to get things done. And whether you're talking about constitutional carry, throwing out rules and regulations, a balanced budget, business tax cuts, full day kindergarten, you know, the rape shield laws that we passed. I mean, I could go through a list of the hundreds of things that I think have just been huge successes. We've done it by throwing politics out, working bipartisan, working with both sides of the aisle, trying to understand both sides of the issues, and at the end of the day, moving forward, real action.
You can read more of our interview with Governor Sununu in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
With December well underway, holiday craft fairs have been taking place. On Saturday, the Chronicle visited events at St. Albert's Church in West Stewartstown and at the Monadnock Congregational Church in Colebrook. Santa came to Colebrook on Sunday with Mr. and Mrs. Claus arriving in style by fire truck to a gathered crew on Main Street. Santa fulfilled his annual tradition of lighting the Christmas tree in the center of town. Then the pair moved to the Colebrook School Gymnasium, where a line of eager children reached all the way around the gym to the door. Santa then sat down and began the long task of listening to the Christmas wishes of each and every youngster. The duo of Mr. and Mrs. Claus found time on Sunday to also drop by the hut above the border. Nearly two dozen children were eagerly awaiting the arrival of St. Nick, while Mrs. Claus was busy making crafts with the children.
And they couldn't come with me.
Last Friday, December 1st, saw the official holiday illumination activities in downtown Coaticook, Quebec. Child Street was closed off as families showed up in droves to enjoy ice cream plus hot dogs that they could cook over open pits amid giant elves on stilts and music. And everywhere there were lights, which heralded in the Christmas season.
Thank you.
On Tuesday evening, the Rialto Theater in Lancaster was decked out in the lights and colors of Christmas for a celebration of Irish music. The Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts presented the performance called An Irish Christmas in America, which was a showcase of story, song, and dance.
Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Expect a high of 32 degrees on Friday with a low of 17. Saturday temps hit a high of 33, and Sunday brings snowfall with a high of 28 and a low of 13. On Saturday, the Colebrook Booster Club hosted the championship matchups of their junior high basketball tournament, with the Canaan-Pittsburgh girls and the Groveton boys heading home as the victors. Watching the video news of the week.